Welcome back, folks, and I've been waiting a while to be able to deliver this next part in my Thorns TD-160 restoration and upgrade series of videos on Audio Karma and YouTube. And so this is part, I think it's part 7. Anyway, we'll figure that one out here shortly. But one of the best bang for the dollars upgrades I find for these turntables, and this is this pertains basically to purely manual tables. As you know, you can get semi-automatic and automatic. There is the TD-145, 146 versions of this turntable that have an auto lift, and it'll shut off once you finish playing the record. But the early generations and the 160 series and 165, 166, I believe, are all manual turntables. And they don't afford all of the luxuries that come with an auto lift and shut off. So what ends up happening if you play a record and fall asleep or get busy doing something else and you're not there for when the record side ends, then you have a stylus spinning on a platter indefinitely until you come back and lift it and stop it manually. So way back in the day, Thorns actually had a Thorns version of this, and it's called the Q-Up. So it's an automatic tone arm lifter, and I use it on every one of my Thorns turntable. This is the newest one I got in my collection, so I didn't have one for this yet, so I ordered it online. You can see my old British sort of turntable here, and right there you can see a Q-Up tone arm lifter or Q-Up lever. And so I'm going to do the same thing to this turntable, and basically it goes in the same location right next to where the arm swings over, and when it reaches to the end it clicks this little button here and trips it up, and then lifts the needle or the stylus and the tone arm off the record, but it will still remain spinning. So the platter will continue to rotate until you actually stop it, but at least it will save wear and tear on your valuable stylus and cartridge combination. So what we'll do is we'll go through a little bit of how to set it up, and usually I find it works almost 100% of the time. There's the odd record you'll find with a label, it's a different size, and it might trip it up, but for the most part I've run into very, very few of those, and this is about a 98% successful lifter at the end of a record side. So comes in this handy little box. Thorns, as I mentioned, back in the 70s, early 80s, marketed one. It was exactly the same thing as this, except it said Thorns, and it was called the Thorns Q-Up. This, I think the company was bought out by a gentleman in Toronto, in Canada here. And where you can get them, I got this one on eBay. It's a little bit cheaper than if you go to the website here, which is thequp.com. But they do have good American pricing here for shipping down to the States. So you can go to the website and, you know, go on eBay or even Amazon, I think, sells them, and figure out which is going to be the least expensive for you. The company is called Palmer Enterprises. The gentleman there is actually a nice fellow. I've bought quite a few, and I've had a few interchanges with him. He's very knowledgeable about these. I think they look spiffy. I think they look like they match the system, because you got the black, parts on the tone arm, and it's the black, and it is plastic, but it's actually a very robust plastic. There's different settings on it. So here's your trigger. So when the arm comes over and plays out, it'll hit this little trigger right here, and it kicks that thing up, which lifts the arm off the stylus off the playing record. And then you just, to reset it, all you do to recock it, all you have to do is push it down. There's a slider on each side. One is a slider to control how violent of an action that that arm takes in lifting up the arm, because I guess it has to handle a whole wide variety of types of tone arms. And then there's also one that actually adjusts the sensitivity of that switch, whether it's a hair trigger or requires a little bit more muscle in order to activate the lifter. So I've done a video previously. I'll link it in the video below and show that's how that's done. And what I'll do is I'll unpackage this and show you the bits and pieces that come with it. And it doesn't fit all. So if you go to the website, it'll actually tell you what kinds of turntables it will work with. Will not work with DJ type style turntables like the SL1200 Techniques turntables, because their base is too big and there's not enough room to actually do the lifting maneuver on those types of turntables. He does have a database, I think, of turntables that this is known to work with. I think Regas will work with it. All of the Thorns, Linz, numbers of turntables out there that this will work with. So just before you buy it, make sure that it's compatible with your turntable. I find these are really, really good with the Thorns, and I use these exclusively with the Thorns. I have a Lenco upstairs that has an auto lifter, which this does not work with, a Lenco L70, and I had to use a Duke Audio one, which is not as reliable as these, I find. So we'll take a pause here. I'm one-handed, I'm hand bombing this video, so what I'll do is I'll lay out what the parts are, and then we'll do a little bit of an explanation there. All right, I've opened up the box here. Interestingly enough, there was no instructions inside. There's a little bit of a blurb on the back that you can read. But best go online, because they actually have videos on how to set these things up, and as well as basically a manual online where you can actually, it tells you what all the buttons do, and there's only two sliders, and that's it. So one bag is the device itself plus a spare double-sided piece of tape, and then there's these base pads in the other bag. And there are various heights depending on the configuration of your turntable. If you've got one of those turntables with a really thick platter, obviously you'd want a taller base plate to put your cue-up lever on. With the Thorns TD160 series of turntables, excluding the auto lift versions, which don't need it because it's built into the turntables, this is the way to go, because you don't require any of these base pads. They're just the right height the way they are. In fact, it comes with the device, it comes in this sort of slotted tray, I guess you'd call it. I'm trying to do this one-handed and film it at the same time, but it's not cooperating. There we go. So really, this is the base mount that you can see, and then there's a double-sided piece of tape, and then you just sort of eyeball it here, and you may have to adjust this, the angle of your, this is adjustable with a hex screw. You can actually pivot that. It's not really in the way here. You can just plunk it like that, and then once it's glued on into the suitable place, normally you would place it with this, and then you can adjust it forward and aft. Just within the slide, so within this little holder here, and there's little grooves on the inside, and little groove on the outside here, and they made up, and you can actually slide back and forth, and it holds it in place without having it slip and slide all over the place. Now, what you would want to do is place it so when the arm comes over. When it hits that trigger, it's going to lift the arm in the appropriate place. And that's where this adjustment comes in. You can adjust the height of this just by sliding this in. So there, it's much higher. So you can lift it up, and as you can see, it's too high. And if you want to move it, you can just move this within the holder once it's glued in to fine-tune your adjustment. As I say, there's videos on the on this website right here, thequp.com, that actually walks you through the setup process. So I'm not going to do that. I'd be reinventing the wheel kind of thing. So I urge you to go there and see how that's set up. And most of these things, I just keep them in the box. If you actually want to transfer it to another turntable, another type of turntable, you can do that, and that way you have the parts available. So we'll set that up, very similar to this one, as you can see. You can see how I've moved over the auto lifter here on this one. So I'll do likewise on this turntable, and we'll get it all set up, and I'll do a demonstration of how it works. Before I do that, I'll go through the this is the so they have a printable version of the manual online, and then it goes through the features. So here's your base unit, and then as you scroll down, you can see the outside on the opposite side of the arm. That slider there adjusts the lift force sensitivity, and that's how violent or how soft that lifter device actually lifts up your arm, because you don't want to have it come up very violently and throw your arm up into the air. You want to have it just with enough force to lift it up and basically keep it in contact with that without having to abuse your tone arm when it's being lifted off the record. Then of course the one in the front underneath the trigger is a trigger sensitivity adjuster. So if you find what's happening is the arm is sliding over, it hits that trigger and it doesn't actually trip off the lifting mechanism, then it's not sensitive enough. So you can actually adjust that to make it more of a hair trigger in order to lift up your arm. And there's your arm, which is the actual tone arm lifter. And then it goes through a number of installation concepts. So there's a video, and there you go. That walks you right through the whole process. All right, I've got it all set up now, and it's working great. I've got a little demo disc here, a demo LP that I'll play the end of, and you can just see it functioning for yourself. We'll drop the record, drop the needle or stylus near the end, and we'll watch it go through its run out. A little Vangelis. You can see it coming towards the end there. That's a Goldring E3 cartridge. You can see how it's set up there. So when it actually gets to the runout of the side of the LP, it will trigger the mechanism, which will lift the arm and take the stylus off the record and continue to spin. Go. So that's the end of the side, and it lifts off, and no more stylus wear. So if you forget about it and you're out doing some chores in the house, or you fall asleep, you can rest assured that you will not wear out your stylus if you sleep the night. The one thing that I will note is, of course, the turntable remains spinning. It does not shut off the turntable. But at the very least, it's protecting your valuable stylus. If you left it for weeks on end, then obviously you might wear out your belt, but belts are easily replaceable. I tend to, not let them run all night long. I just, when you notice that your turntable has been, the record side has been complete, you can just shut her off and then carry on. So there you have it, and then you just basically lift your cue, slide this over, because once it falls off the arm, you don't want it to fall down into your record, and then you just reset the trigger, and you're ready for the next play. And then you would just play it out. It would come to the end and trigger and lift your tone arm off. I think this is one of the best values, best tweaks for these types of turntables, for the fully manual turntable. It saves a lot of wear and tear on your stylus. It's a very functional device. And actually, if you look at the tone arm with its black finishes and everything, it actually matches very well with the TD-160 turntable. Like my black Thorins, the black head shell, all of the accoutrements on the tone arm assembly, as well as the black strip here, it just goes very well with it. And as I said before, these were actually marketed by Thorins way back in the day, and then Palmer Industries basically bought them out, and it's a good thing that they're still around today, because they're not only effective on Thorins turntables, but there's a whole host of other turntables that you can go on their website and find out which ones it's compatible with. So thank you for watching, and highly recommend this. I've got four Thorins turntables right now, and all four of them have this tone arm lifter. I find that they're that effective. So thank you for watching.